Welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Professor Rani Sadashiva Murthy from the Department of Sahitya, Rashtriya Sanskrit Vidyapeetha, Tirupati. The subject is Indian culture. The paper is on Vedic, Epic and Puranic culture of India, and the present module deals with the importance of Bhagavata Purana and Vishnu Purana. We know that out of the 18 Mahapuranas, the very popular Purana is Bhagavata Purana, and Vishnu Purana also is equally virtuous and equally respected by all the people among all the Puranas. That's why in this module we are going to know about both the Mahapuranas, Bhagavata Purana and also Vishnu Purana, and about their contents and the value of the contents also. Here, Bhagavata Purana, out of the 18 Mahapuranas, 6 Puranas are considered to be Sattvic Puranas. One among those Sattvic Puranas is Bhagavata Purana. And this Purana is at present available in 18,000 shlokas. This Purana is otherwise called Bhakti Shastra. As the Vedas and the Upanishads preach about the importance of Jnana, Bhagavata Purana highlights the importance of Bhakti in human life. Particularly, Bhakti towards Vishnu is highlighted here. And this Bhagavata Purana is divided into 12 skandhas, and very beautifully, there is an attempt to synchronize the thoughts on moksha, jnana, bhakti, karma, and all other aspects. Besides this, as the object of meditation, there are 23 forms recommended by Bhagavata Purana to contemplate upon. Those 23 are known as 23 avatars of Vishnu. Besides the 10 avatars, dashavataras, 13 more avatars are added in Bhagavata Purana. And this is a wonderful thesis, we can say, because in the third chapter of the first skandha of this Bhagavata, they have enlisted the names of all the 23 avatars, and then they have given a brief introduction about all these 23 avatars. Later, in the rest of the 11 skandhas, the detailed account of all these 23 avatars is given. That's why Bhagavata is paired for the very beautiful narration of the story of Sri Krishna and also of all the other avatars. And now we proceed to know about various aspects of the contents of skandhas. In the first skandha, there was a wonderful beginning in the Naimisharanya, where a confluence of sages with Shaunaka, to whom Vedavyasa handed over all the Puranas. That Shaunaka was there, and in front of the sage Shaunaka, all the other almost thousands of sages came together, gathered together, and they wanted to learn about the Bhagavata Shastra or Bhagavata Purana under him. And he began with the conversation between Vedavyasa and Narada. And there itself, contextually, the story of Parikshit was started at the end of the Mahabharata war. After the departure of Pandavas to the Mahaprasthana, Parikshit became the king. Who is this Parikshit? Parikshit was the son of Abhimanyu. Abhimanyu was the son of Arjuna, and Abhimanyu's wife was Uttara. Because of the anger of Ashwatthama over Pandavas, Ashwatthama hurled the astra of Brahmashirshaka, and because of the effect of Brahmashirshaka, all the Pandavas, along with their race, he intended to get destroyed by the influence and effect of Brahmashirshaka, and he used it. But Vedavyasa and others came there. They requested Arjuna to withdraw the astra which was used by Ashwatthama, and by power of penance, Arjuna withdrew the astra, but by the time the effect of the astra was working, the effect of the astra was working over the child in the womb of Uttara, that was Parikshit. Then Sri Krishna used Sudarshan Chakra as a protector of the child, and because that child in his mother's womb was protected by Sri Krishna, he was known as Parikshit, who was protected from all sides. So such Parikshit became the ruler of Hastinapura after the departure of Pandavas. And once this Parikshit insulted a sage who was in penance in a forest when he went there for hunting. As a result, he was cursed by the son of that sage to die within 7 days. Having known this, Parikshit was repenting in the Antapura. There came the sage Shukadeva, and he wanted to impart the knowledge of Bhagavata, by hearing which he assured that Parikshit would get moksha within the 7th day. So this Prathama Skandha has such a content where the Vishnu's glory was praised by Shukadeva in many ways through all the skandhas. So this skandha too, this is about the process of attaining moksha, and then cosmic form of Vishnu and worship of Vishnu as well as the other gods, the difference between, and description of the cosmic and its creation process are very detailedly explained in the Dvitiya Skandha, in the second Skandha. In this process, they say that worshipping all the other gods may result in giving some desired fruits only. But if Vishnu is worshipped, moksha is definite. Such an assurance was given in the Dvitiya Skandha. And then, Sargasyadha Visargascha Vritti Rakshantaranija Vamsho Vamsanijaritam Samstha Hetarapashrayaha. These are the 10 characteristics of Puranas. These were explained in the beginning of the second Skandha, and they promise that out of the 10 Lakshanas of Purana, the last one is Apashraya Moksha. For the sake of attaining moksha, one is recommended to follow the rest of the 9 other characteristics of this Purana, Bhagavata Purana. In this manner, the first and second skandhas are over. And now we proceed to the 3rd and 4th skandha. In the 3rd skandha, there was a meet of Vidura and Uddhava. Uddhava was dearest to Sri Krishna, and Vidura was from the Pandavas advisors. These two met, and interestingly, there were mentioning of 10 ways of creation, and this tenfold creation is described like this. There were 2 elements in the creation. One is Prakriti and the other one is Vikriti. This Prakriti is the cause, and Vikritis are the evolutes from the Prakriti. The entire creation is divided into 10 types as 6 Prakritika creations and 4 Vaikritik creations. Out of the six Prakritik creations, first one is Mahat, creation of Mahat. Mahat is Buddhi. As every human being or every being has Buddhi, similarly, the universe also has Buddhi. That is Buddhi of Virat Purusha. So, that Buddhi is created. And then Aham, as we have the I consciousness, universe also has I consciousness, which is called Ahankara or Aham, and that Aham was created. After Aham, Bhutas, Panchabhutas were created. These Panchabhutas are Prithvi, Ap, Tejo, Vayu and Akasha. The earth, water, air, fire and ether, these were created. After this, Indriyas, Panchajnanendriyas and Panchakarmendriyas are created. Similarly, five Tanmatras, subtle elements also are created. Then Vaikarikas and the Vikaras of these Indriyas, Bhutas and all these things, they were created. After this, Tamas also is created. In this manner, Mahat, Ahamkara, Bhutas, Indriyas, Vaikarikas and Tamas are the sixfold aspects of creation which belong to the Prakriti aspect. And regarding the Vikriti, there are four types. Rajas Sarga, Mukhya Sarga of trees and plants, and then animals, and then the creation of human beings, and finally the creation of sages and others. All this come under the Vaikritika Sarga. So in this manner, Prakritika Sarga, the creation of the causal world, and Vaikritika Sarga is the creation of the effects. And from the Vaikritika Sarga, the prototypes of all beings, living and non-living beings, were created, and the creation continued depending on the Vaikritika Sarga in the modern times. Sarga means creation according to Puranas. So, the fourth skandha deals with the performance of Yajna by Daksha, which was destroyed by the Virabhadra and other Pramadaganas of Shiva because of the unwanted happenings and because of the arrogance of Daksha. And then after this Daksha Yajna Vinasha, Dhruvopakhyana. This Dhruvopakhyana is a wonderful Upakhyana, which proves that to please Vishnu, one need not be a grown-up person. Even a young child can get lot of energy and lot of powers and lot of grace from Vishnu by observing penance. This was the essence of Dhruvopakhyana. Here, Dhruva, a boy of 5 years old, who was neglected by his stepmother, and by the advice of his mother, he goes into the forest to start penance in praise of Vishnu. Narada came and imparted the Narayana mantra to Dhruva, and with the help of this Narayana mantra, Dhruva pleased Vishnu and attained the highest place in the entire universe, which is even above to all the Saptalokas, and just on par with the Saptarshi Mandala, and which is on the side of Vishnu Loka. That is Dhruvasthana. He attained, this boy attained that Dhruvasthana by the grace of Vishnu. And this is a wonderful system, and this Upakhyana is a great informative system about the creation. And then the story of King Vena is available in the Skandha 4. Vena was the first divine being who was appointed to rule the universe, but his misbehavior with the sages made them to get angry with him, and they cursed him to die. And then Vena had fallen dead, and from the body of Vena, all the sages and gods churned and produced another child whose name was Prithu, and the son of Vena, Prithu, became the first king of the universe. And so this story also, Prithu Chakravarti's story also, is available in the Bhagavata. Then stories of Sanachatushtaya. This Sanachatushtaya are the incarnations of Vishnu only. They are always very young in appearance. They are known as 5 years old boys always, and but their jnana is highest jnana they attained. That's why this Sanachatushtaya is Sanaka, Sanandana, Sanat Kumara, Sanat Sujata. These were born, and the story of this Sanachatushtaya is available in the fourth skandha of Bhagavata. And also Prachetas. Prachetas is the other name of Varuna. So Varuna's origin also is explained in the Bhagavata. And after this, skandha 5. This fifth skandha deals with the stories of Priyavrata, Rishabhadeva, Jadabharata, and then Brahmanda Swarupa with the seven Vipas also is explained. As we know, Rishabhadeva was the Atmajnani and highest philosopher. His son was Jadabharata. And this Jadabharata was such a practitioner of yoga and Atmajnana that while he was in his mortal body itself, Devadutas, the messengers from the heaven, came and they invited him to become a permanent person to stay in heaven. But he didn't hear, because while they were going there, he saw a deer and he wanted to offer water to it. So he jumped out from the Vimana and he reached the place where the deer was. He offered water to it. As a result, Karma Pasha, a bonding was there between that deer and himself, and he had to take 3 more births to reach heavens. This story of Jadabharata is very excellently explained in the Bhagavata. And after that, the Brahmanda Swarupa. The geographical aspects available in Puranas are very astonishing, and here in the Bhagavata, the geographical aspects of Brahmanda, the geographical aspects of the earth, and then the geographical aspects of Bharatavarsha and Bharatakanda, all are given in detail in this Skandha 5. So here in the Brahmanda Swarupa, the description of the 7 Dvipas, that is Jambudvipa, Prichadvipa, Kraunchadvipa, Kushadvipa, Shakadvipa, and then Pushkaradvipa, all these Dvipas were well explained. Here particularly, the Jambudvipa is entire earth on which human beings are dwelling. According to some scholars, all the Dvipas, 7 Dvipas, they tried to find in the globe itself, human globe itself. But it is a wrong conception according to some other scholars. So in this manner, Brahmanda Swarupa is explained. And then Lokaloka mountain. Lokaloka mountain's nature is such that on one side of the mountain, it is fully bright, and on the other side, it is dark. So such parvata is known as Lokaloka parvata, which is parting this Brahmanda from the other Brahmandas. Anantakoti Brahmandas, innumerable galaxies are there. One galaxy is equal to one Brahmanda. So here the description of Lokaloka Parvata is very interesting, that it parts this Brahmanda in which we are dwelling from the other Brahmandas, other galaxies. And then story of Ajamila was given in the Skandha 6. Here, Ajamila was a person who never had any devotion towards the God, and he never behaved properly, or he never followed the moral principles. He was very immoral, and he clung to all kinds of vices. But at the end of his life, while dying, he called his son, whose name was Narayana. So accidentally he called Narayana, Narayana, please come, like that. That name, utterance of the name of Narayana, reached the ears of Lord Vishnu. While dying, he uttered the name, whether it is mine or whether it is of a human being. When he says Narayana, he should be reaching this Vaikuntha, but not any other place. So he sent the messengers of Vaishnuloka to bring the soul of Ajamila to stay permanently in the Vaikuntha. At the same time, the messengers of Yama from hell also came there. There was a clash between the messengers of Yama and also the messengers of Vishnu, and ultimately because of his utterance of Narayana Shabda, he was judged to be taken to Vaikuntha only. So Sravanam, Kirtanam Vishnu, Smaranam, Padasevanam, all this lead to be graced by Vishnu. This is a direct example. And then we have Bhagavata Dharma details also in this Bhagavata Purana. This is the content of 6th Skandha. The 7th Skandha has the details of Narasimha Avatara. Narasimha is a form, a mixed form of lion head and human body. Because of his interest in his devotee Prahlada, Lord Vishnu assumed the form of Narasimha, and he had to kill the demon Hiranyakashipu to save Dharma and to stop Adharma. And after that, we have a detailed account of the duties of various castes and also duties of various varnas and ashramas, stages of life, in the last chapters of the 7th Skandha, in the conversation of Yudhishthira and Narada. So in this manner they were given, and those principles which were instructed there at the end of 7th Skandha are followable even today by all the human beings. So then Skandha 8, the most popular story of Gajendra Moksha, an excellent example of Sharanagati. As far as we think that we can do, God's help will be the least. And when we surrender ourselves totally to Vishnu, Vishnu will be our protector. So this should be understood. This Gajendra Moksha is an excellent example of this. And after Gajendra Moksha, we have the story of churning of milky ocean by gods and demons to obtain Amrita. In the process of Sagara Mathana, the mountain Manthara, which was made the churning stick, was about to drown in the Kshira Samudra. Then all the gods and demons together praised Vishnu to save them, and Vishnu assumed the form of Mahakurma, and that Kurma Avatara details are available in Skandha 8. Ashtama Skandha. After Kurma Avatara, we have the details of Dhanvantari, the first doctor, and the origin of Indian medicine was through Dhanvantari. So that Dhanvantari is episode. Dhanvantari also was an incarnation of Vishnu that is available there. And after that, Mohini Avatara, a wonderfully beautiful woman, was the incarnation of Vishnu, which was known as Mohini, Trijagan Mohini Swarupa, and having thrown both the gods, demons, and all the beings of all the worlds in a mood of infatuation, when there was a clash between the demons and gods about the distribution of Amrita after the churning of Kshira Samudra. Mohini came there, took the pot of Amrita into the hands, and all were in infatuation. Then she started distributing Amrita only to the gods and avoided the demons, and ultimately she helped gods in killing the demons. So that was the purpose of the incarnation of Mohini, and that instance of Mohini avatara also is available in the Bhagavata. After this, the story of Vamana and also the story of the great Matsya, Matsya avatara, also is available here. Here one interesting thing is there. In the list of the dashavataras, we start the count from Matsya. But here in the Bhagavata, in the Ashtama Skandha, after Vamana avatara, the description of Matsya avatara is available. It is a point to be noted. And then we have 9th Skandha, where the stories of Vaivashvatavanu and Chavana, Ambarisha, Harishchandra and Sagara, Bhagiratha, Sri Rama, Parashurama, Yayati, Dushyanta and Bharata, along with these people, the four sons of Pururava, Anu, Drushyu, Turvasu and Yadu. These are all narrated there in the 9th Skandha. And here some of them are Maharajas, some of them are Chakravartis, Shat Chakravartis and Shodasa Maharajas. Among these, the mostly popular Chakravartis and Maharajas are depicted here along with their stories. And after this, Dashama Skandha. This is one of the most beautiful skandhas, one of the most beautiful texts in the entire Sanskrit literature, because the entire Dashama Skandha is paired for depicting the story of Sri Krishna, marriage of Balrama, the construction of Dwarka city itself is a very interesting one, and that building of Dwarka city is available here. And after that, Jarasandha, who tried to invade repeatedly, over and again, he tried to attack Lord Krishna. Every time Lord Krishna was defeating Jarasandha, and 18th time he left. And after that, with the help of Bhimasena and Arjuna, during the time of performing Rajasuya Yaga by Yudhishthira, he took Bhima to the kingdom of Jarasandha, who was ruling Magadha, the present Patna, and then through Bhima, he made Jarasandha to be killed. This account also is available in the Bhagavata. And after that, the meeting of Sri Krishna and Sudama, his childhood friend, and also the great description of Rasalila and the slaying of Shishupala, all were the accounts in Dashama Skandha. And coming to the next two skandhas, Ekadasa Skandha, various aspects of bhakti and jnana, like satsanga, siddhis, the 8 siddhis, anima, laghima, mahima, prapti, prakamya, ishitva and vashitva, these are the ashta siddhis, which can be attained by worshipping Vishnu. All these were explained. And after that, Sankhya Yoga, Jnana Yoga, Karma Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, all these kinds of yogas were explained. And then yoga of formal worship, Samurti Aradhana, and the importance of yoga in Samurti Aradhana also is highlighted. And after that, we have the 12th Skandha, where the line of kings in Kali is, and fourfold pralaya, Vedas and Veda Shakas, all these things were explained. Finally, having heard all these things, through Shukadeva, Parikshit attains moksha. With this attaining of moksha by Parikshit, this Bhagavata of 12 Skandhas ends. In this Bhagavata, in this manner, we have very interesting aspects, excellently clubbed. The story is clubbed with shastras, and we have the principles of Advaita in this Bhagavata, the principles of Bhakti, the principles of Sankhya and Yoga, the principles of all other darshanas can be comfortably seen in this great text. That's why Bhagavata is highly respected by both scholarly circle and also the devotees. Now we proceed to know about Vishnu Purana. This Vishnu Purana is equally valuable and equally respectful to all the lovers of ancient Indian Sanskrit literature. And this Vishnu Purana presently is available in 23,000 shlokas. This is also one of the six sattvic Puranas in the Mahapurana division. And this Vishnu Purana, as the title does suggest, deal with all the vibhutis and aspects of Vishnu. And this Vishnu Purana is considered to be the greatest one with six amshas in it. This Vishnu Purana with six amshas gives us a very picturesque aspects of Vishnu. These six amshas of Vishnu Purana are divided into 126 adhyayas, and this first amsha deals with the dialogue between the sage Maitreya and Parashara. So, as suggested here, this is narrated, this Vishnu Purana is narrated by Maitreya to Parashara. And lifespan of Brahma, Kalpanta Srishti aspect of creation, and gods, sages, etc. is explained here. And creation of human beings, stories of Bhrigu, Dhruva, Prithu, Prahlada, slain of Hiranyakashipu, various vibhutis of Vishnu are in detail explained here. It seems that the stories of Prahlada, Bhrigu, etc. look like the repetitions of what are available in the Bhagavata, but in the presentation there is a great variation and it creates interest in reading these stories here in Vishnu Purana also. And then Amsha 2, description of the seven Dvipas and Khagola description. Khagola is astronomy. Astronomically, the position of all the grahas, planets and stars and other the celestial bodies is interestingly explained here. And after that, the description of the seven celestial worlds, Bhuvarloka, Suvarloka, Janaloka, Tapoloka, Ajoloka, Satyalokas. All these available. Similarly about the Sapta Patalas, Atala, Vitala, Sutala, Talatala, Rasatala, Patalas. All these are explained there. And then the story of Jalabharata and the story of Savvira and the story of Rubhus. All are there. And after that, in the Amsha 3, we have the calculation of Manvantaras. Here, we have to get some knowledge. Kali is in human years is of 4,32,000 years. And Dwapara is double to Kali is, so 8,64,000 years. If one Kali is added to Dwapara Yuga, that is 12,96,000 years is the length of Treta Yuga. And one more Kali Yuga, if is added to Treta Yuga, that is 17,28,000 years, that is the span of Krita Yuga. So, all these four Yugas make one Mahayuga. And such 1,000 Mahayugas make one Kalpa, a day span of Brahma's life. During the day span of Brahma, 14 Manus are born and they get decay. That's why the lifespan of each Manu is 71 Mahayugas. In this manner, we have the passing of 14 Manvantaras during the present Kalpa, Shvetavaraha Kalpa. And the details of all those Manus are available here. The first Manu was Swayambhu Manu, and following him, there are other Manus. The presently, we have the Vaivasvata Manus era in progress. And during these Manvantaras, totally in a Kalpa, there will be 28 manvantaras. Out of 28 manvantaras, so far we have 14 manvantaras, and now in each manvantara there will be one Vedavyasa, and in this manner the names of the 28 Vedavyasas are also available in the Bhagavata and also in Vishnu Purana. And then Kalpa Parimana, Kalpa's length, 1000 Mahayugas is given here. And then the incarnation of Buddha for the destruction of Tripuras also very beautifully explained in this. Next, the Amsha 4. This Amsha gives us the details of Vamsha Charita, the birth of Surya Vamsha and also Chandra Vamsha, the stories of Daksha, Pururavas, Ikshvaku, Kakustha, and then Sagara, Vishwamitra, Kushadvaja, and Dhanvantari, Nahusha, Yayati, Yaduvamsha, and Kroshtravamsha, etc. All these are available in the fourth Amsha. And after fourth Amsha, we go to the next one, the fifth Amsha, that is story of Sri Krishna from the birth to Niryana. Very detailed account. The Krishna's story is available in four sources popularly. One is Bhagavata, the second one is Vishnu Purana, and the third one is Brahmavivarta Purana, and the fourth one is Harivamsha. But here in Vishnu Purana, from the birth to the Nirvana, in a single source we can see. Very beautifully explained, and even excelling the accounts found in all other texts, we have a beautiful narration of the story of Krishna here in this fifth Amsha of Vishnu Purana. And next we have the description of Kali is four types of pralayas: Atyantika pralaya, Naimittika pralaya, Nitya pralaya. Like that, there are many kinds of pralayas. All kinds of dissolution are explained in this sixth Amsha. In this manner, Vishnu Purana gives us lots of information about the vibhutis of Vishnu, various incarnations of Vishnu, and also various details. Coming to the end, we can say that this Bhagavata and Vishnu Purana, both are Mahapuranas, both are Sattvic Puranas, both extol the glory of Vishnu, and both of them have a balanced blend of all the required qualities of a Mahapurana, and the story part and also the Shastra part are well mixed in these two Puranas. These are the things to be known while studying these Mahapuranas, Bhagavata and Vishnu Purana.